So Brandon Krause, 2015, kicked off. You're already starting to go to shows. Tell me about the show and tell me about your fighter that's going to be at the show.
We have our first fight of the year, Sunday in the beautiful city of Pacoima. And we got super classy Sharif Coleman trying to get another win. Been doing really well, been training hard, been sparring hard, been doing all the things that you need to do to be successful in boxing.
What advice do you give Sharif or amateur fighters watching this? This is, how does this work? You go in, you one fight, and that's it. It's not a tournament, right?
So this is a local show, and Sharif's going to show up with his passbook that shows that he's registered through USA Boxing.
That's why he has USA shirt on.
And he's going to weigh in, and then he's going to try to match up with another opponent of similar experience and somewhere within 9 pounds up or down of his particular weight.
Okay.
So it's not like a tournament in which he would have to make a weight class. This one we have that 9 pounds leeway either direction.
What weight class does he fight at?
152.
So you could fight someone 159 or 143, right?
Yeah.
What advice do you give him? Like, what? This is your fifth fight? Fourth fight?
Eighth fight.
Okay. So he's still early in his career as an amateur.
Yes.
What should fighters do the day of the fight? Do they eat a big breakfast? Do you starve? Do you not eat? Do you drink?
Like, well, you gotta weigh in the amateurs the day of your fight. So the typical modus operandi is that we stop eating the day before around 6.
In the evening?
No, I'm not talking anything crazy. I'm talking like starving yourself for days in and days out and stuff like that. Because it's not worth it, because you may end up fighting somebody bigger than you anyway. But you stop eating around 6. You wake up. We all meet up usually at the gym as a team. And we go to wherever the fights may be, you know, all around the greater Southern California area. And when we get there, we get on the scale. We get our weight recorded by the official recorder. And then we eat. Then we eat breakfast. That's probably 10 a.m. The fights start at 1, so we have 2-3 hours for the food to be digested, and I think that's also the proper amount of time. At least when I'm present, I try to really watch what these young men and women eat for breakfast.
So no fast food, no...
Well, when I'm not around, you know, God knows what they put in their mouth.
That's what everybody does.
You know what
I
mean? I've had guys, before the fight eating chili dogs, and I have to go and slap it out of their hands, you know.
That can give you upset stomach.
Remember David eating the chili dog, Jesse?
That could give you the runs.
He took fucking 2 hours before fighting eating the chili dog.
Man, he was hungry.
Whatever. Anyways, and then, you know, you get back to the fight. There's a lot of things that the coaches have to do. The coaches have to try to get you. Later, Kim. The coaches have to try to get you a match, make sure the match is good, make sure you're at a particular place on the fight card. Because, like I said, the fights start at 1 p.m., but there could be 25 fights on the card. And if you figure there's only about 4 or 5 fights an hour, it's a pretty long day.
It is, and I've been in some of these fights where it's midnight, literally midnight, 11:45 before you step in the ring. It happened to you in Oxnard a couple years ago at the tournament.
It's happened at a number of fighters, and personally, when I used to fight, I ended up fighting in one tournament at like 2 a.m. or something like that. It was crazy.
If people are watching this, and they're fighters, professional athletes that I've seen them the day of the fight, they eat oatmeal, they eat brown rice, maybe chicken. What do you recommend amateur fighters to eat the day of the fight?
You want to have like a 3-to-1 ratio of carbs to protein. You don't need any fat, particularly for that time. You have plenty of stored fat that will be accessible if you need that as an energy source, and it's hard to digest the fat also. I would stay away from any type of dense meat and try to get the protein, you know, be a more easily digestible source like eggs or something like that.
How about chicken?
Chicken, you know, it's easier. Fish? It's easier to digest than red meat, but not as easy as fish. Yeah,
fish.
But it also, look, this should be said. I can have all the book knowledge in the world of what, you know, top athletes are supposed to do, but if a fighter comes and they have some sort of ritual that they already go through that puts them in their arousal zone to get ready for a fight, I don't necessarily want to disrupt that, even though if it doesn't exactly go by the book of what's supposed to happen. So some of my fighters like to do things that me as a kinesiologist me as an athletic trainer, I know there's better ways to go about it, but this is how they feel comfortable. This is what they're used to. And I wouldn't want to choose just a few hours before the fight to really introduce something new to them.
So if they eat greasy food, a McDonald's burger, like you said, a hot chili, and that's their routine?
You know, like, for instance, yeah, they want McDonald's breakfast item instead of something I suggest. I let them go to the McDonald's. Man, I'll watch what they order, you know what I mean? But I won't, even though I know better that they shouldn't eat that ever, you know, I'm not going to change that. If McDonald's is their lucky food before a fight, then motherfucker, let's go eat some McDonald's.
That's it. How about people get butterflies before a fight? How do you calm them down, coach? Everybody gets them, even the pros.
Yeah, everybody gets them. They should be gotten because this puts your body in that state of being alert and faster and sharper and more aware of everything. And you know what I do, Ellie? Is you call it butterflies, you say nervous, but I tell my fighters that what you're feeling is not being nervous, it's being excited, you know, not what, you don't feel butterflies, you feel a focus starting, and I try to change the definitions of these processes that are happening to your body. So somebody inexperienced can come to me and go, coach, my heart won't stop beating, my stomach's upset, I can't, it's hard to focus, I'm so nervous, and I go, no, you're so excited. Your stomach's upset because it doesn't need the task of digestion right now. It needs to get ready for the fight. Your heart's beating because it's trying to supply your body with enough blood and oxygen as possible. And it's difficult to focus because you don't need to think about, you know, what you're going to buy later today or what you're going to do for your girlfriend tomorrow. You need to think about this one acute fight, and that's why you're getting the tunnel vision. So I just really try to change the definitions of these things to my fighters.
Like you say, when they lift weights, pain is weakness leaving your body.
I don't say that, but sure.
But that's the same philosophy, basically.
There you go, Ellie.
So there you have it. Last thing, when a fighter steps in the ring finally, what do you tell them to do between, some trainers say stare your opponent in the eye, like mad dog them. What do you tell your fighters? When they step in the ring, they're ready to fight, and they're still like, before the bell sounds or the bell sounds, what's the first?
Well, Jesse, when we go to other gyms, what's the first thing that we're supposed to do?
In front of
him. What?
No, joking around. Like, it's just everybody's a unique individual, and everybody goes about things. You could spit on the floor, though.
That's not polite.
No.
What would you do if someone came in your gym and spit on the floor?
It'd probably be the last floor they ever spit on in their life. But everybody's different. Everybody's personality is different, and I don't have a cookie cutter thing that I tell them. Well, I tell them that I believe in them. And that we're here in the ring because I think they're ready for the challenge, that's for sure. So that goes across the board. You know, I don't have anybody that I'm working a corner for that I don't think is going to win.
There you have it, Brandon Krause. You can see him in Pacoima this weekend. What time is the tournament? 1 p.m.?
1 p.m. the fight starts.
Sunday.
Pacoima Community Center, Sunday. Really good place. They do 4 or 5 shows a year, and they're really good at it. It's a fun afternoon.
Yeah, I've been there a few times. Pretty cool. It's a basketball court, right?
Yeah, it's like a community center.
There you have it. Brandon Krause, SusanReport.com, and Melissa Quack reporting.